I'm going to introduce you to the principal of the University of Glasgow, Principal Muscatelli. The principal is going to be presented by Heather Bryson with a book, and it's over to you, Heather.
Ladies and gentlemen, today I stand before you as the BCYA ambassador to present a gift to Glasgow University's library. I bring with me a book titled Humble Heroes by Ben Shepherd, a collection of extraordinary tales celebrating unsung heroes. I'm still surprised that I'm mentioned within its pages. This gift symbolises gratitude and admiration for Glasgow University's commitment to nurturing compassion and resilience. As you read the stories, may they inspire you to embark on your own journeys. Together, let's recognise the power of our actions, no matter how small, to create positive change in our communities and the world. Thank you to the principal for agreeing to accept the book and for allowing me to share this moment, celebrating the unsung heroes among us. Thank you.
Over to our university library. I'm sure our students and our colleagues will be really grateful to have.
I'll say a couple of words first. I'm actually Heather's mum, Deborah, but everybody knows me as Heather's mum. The reason why she's here today doing the icebreaker is this is what Heather does. And I would really greatly appreciate if everybody joined in to the best of their ability. Can I get you to sit back from the table as much as you can? On your chair, but if you sit back to give yourself a bit of space, I would move your seat back if you can, as far as you can. Now, what Heather will be doing, as I said, is what Heather does and what Heather got most of our recognition for her voluntary work. And it is exercises done by physiotherapists, and they are for everybody. Now, I will be joining in, but I've got a bit of a dodgy shoulder, so when I do it, I will be doing it with one arm. Now, if anybody else feels that way as well, you just do what you can. Heather will talk you through it. We're putting a bit of music on in the background. But it's all about being a bit fun.
Hi there. Thank you.
Hi.
Oh, we've got everything at the same time.
So yeah, and more importantly, it's about maybe smiling and just joining in. So you join in to the best of what you can do, okay? So I'll hand you over to Heather and I'm going to put a bit of music on now while I close this over now. Okay.
Just give me a call.
Stop me now.
Good time.
I bet you've never seen an icebreaker like this before. That's why I'm just saying, do your own thing and smile. It's enough to get his money in there, right?
I've just put together a presentation about me and what I've been doing recently.
Sorry, and if I could get it right. She will refer to me, and this is something, and this is just a prime example of it.
Just use the
arrow.
The arrow
one?
Is it?
For that one?
Yeah,
the arrow one. Oh.
Sorry. You did not want me. You didn't think you needed young people. But you do. My name is Heather Bryson, BCYA Ambassador. I'm 11 years old and I've been asked to explain how and why people and organisations need other kids like me. I'd like to share some of my adventures with you which have led me to being here today. The hope is that organisations will give kids like me the opportunities I've had. As a 7-year-old, I struggled during lockdown and my mental health was affected. Unlike many others, I was lucky enough to find a focus, which just happened to lead me into carrying out volunteering. My adventure started with recycling, making items and selling them at craft fairs, raising money for dementia services. Unfortunately, we went into a second lockdown and my focus just had to change. I wanted to be a YouTuber, my mum, being an old dinosaur,
which just proved it there,
had no idea what a YouTuber was. She told me to go and think of something meaningful to film. I came up with the idea of doing chair exercises for the older and disabled people. My dad and I started to produce exercise videos with the help of the NHS physiotherapists. Which were uploaded to YouTube for everyone to access. Along with these videos and two major events, this gave me a global following, resulting in numerous awards, including the BCYA and a place on the plane to Orlando with Ant and Dec's Saturday Night Takeaway. I've got my boarding pass here. I'm a Ben Shepherd humble hero and appear in his book, hence the reason a copy of this has been gifted to the university this morning. My recycling and chair exercises are just the tip of the iceberg, but I won't bore you with all the details. Why do organisations want me now? The forward-thinking organisations that think out of the box have realised that my generation can bring the skills that no adult can provide. An example of this, I volunteer my time as a buddy with a charity that supports children and young adults with disabilities to participate in sports. As a buddy, I support participants in different ways. If someone is blind, we'll work as a two-person team to catch and pass a ball. If a peer is struggling, it's less, well, it's easier to talk to someone of the same age, and it can be less intimidating. How do kids as young as primary school benefit from volunteering? I've had the opportunity to learn social skills that will stand me in good stead for the years ahead. Confidence, communication skills, public speaking, resilience, just to name a few. How many kids could stand in front of an audience like this without fear? If it wasn't for organisations giving me a chance to volunteer, I would not be here today. I've been invited to places I could only dream of, met people I've seen on TV, but more importantly, I've come into contact with wonderful people making a difference in their own communities. My future is brighter with the skills I have gained and the contacts I have made. How communities benefit? If organisations give us opportunities from a young age, we grow into active members of the community with an ethos of, let's help each other. Our communities have suffered over lockdown. Let's build them back up together. Over these last 3 years, volunteers have halved in numbers. Our communities are feeling the results of this. By widening the age range, we can build the numbers back up and gain volunteers that will possibly be with them throughout school and into the working environment. In the long run, even introducing their own children to the benefits of volunteering. Part of the reason I'm standing here today is to highlight the BCYA for under-18s and the BCA for adults. I've been lucky enough to gain letters after my name. This is my medal. I'm the only Scottish ambassador. My role is to encourage you to nominate the unsung heroes in your area. I will share the link to the BCYA and BCA website on my social media pages, Lockdown Crafts by Age and Lockdown Exercise by Age. I've put cards on the desk, or tables, and or please feel free to speak to me. I like to chat a lot. I'll go back to my opening statement and explain myself. You didn't want me. Before lockdown, my mum tried to get volunteering opportunities that we could do together, but how it was due to my age that nobody wanted us. I think this sums it up. As a young volunteer, I stepped into your sight. You did not want me. I felt the silent right. But I persevered, eager to make a change. With passion ablaze, my dedication unstrained. You see my worth, my value somehow, for as a young volunteer, I've shown you how. The future is brighter if we all think out the box. That's when magic can happen. I'll finish here by asking you to thumbs up and smile.